How many black-owned construction firms do you know? Not very many, right? There's just not very many at all. So when you hear and read about a story like this, you have to give this attention. From my perspective, you got to get this attention. You know? So, you know, this is a really good story, family. Real, real good story. Came across this article from Blavity.com. And this is a black-owned construction company. W.T. Stevens Construction was awarded a government contract to replace 18,000-plus contaminated water pipes in Flint, Michigan. That's incredible. That's incredible. You know, I know that on my channel, there's a lot of new subscribers. I suggest you guys go back and watch my past videos. You know, I always talk about black economic empowerment, things we need to do to start easing off the dominant white society's resources and create our own parallel economy, not depending on the dominant white society's resources. Right? Those are the things I always talk about, and I always talk about the dominant white society controlling all nine areas of activity. That's economics, education, entertainment, labor, law, politics, religion, sex, and war. Right? This right here is beautiful, and this is a great start. You know, you rarely hear about a black-owned construction company. You rarely hear about states or local governments giving out government contracts for black-owned businesses. That's basically a unicorn. So hearing this, reading about this is incredible. So I'm going to read some of the article, family. And, you know, I just want to share this story with you guys. This is great. So it says W.T. Stevens Construction, a black-owned construction firm, has been awarded a multi-million dollar service contract to replace more than 18,000 lead corroded pipes across the city of Flint. Per blackbusiness.org, the construction firm, made up of 25 employees, is one of just four companies recently contracted under a court order to complete the project. Starting in 2014, the Flint water crisis started when over 100,000 residents were potentially exposed to high levels of lead in drinking water, causing a declaration of federal state of emergency in 2016. Flint residents were instructed to use only bottled or filtered water for drinking, cooking, cleaning, bathing, while water quality has returned to acceptable levels this year. Residents are told to continue to use bottled or filtered water until all lead pipes have been replaced. Man, that's crazy. You know, and ever since I heard about the story about Flint, you know, I already knew what time it was. This is nothing new. Poisoning water in a town predominantly populated by blacks or people classified as black. That's nothing new. The dominant white society has been poisoning water. So this is not hyperbole. This is not Alex Jones conspiratorial talk. This is actual facts. Things like this have happened before in the past. You know, all you got to do, you know, look at the past history with Black Wall Street. Right? Look at that. You know what I'm saying? All you got to do is look at predominantly black towns back in the Jim Crow era and see how the dominant white society destroyed those towns in many facets. Many facets. So let me read further in the article. It says, in March 2017, a $97 million settlement from both state and federal funds was approved by a federal magistrate, mandating that thousands of pipes be replaced. Additionally, the state of Michigan has committed to reserving an additional $10 million in case the job requires it. W.T. Stevens was founded by the late black entrepreneur W.T. Stevens back in the 90s. His daughter, Rhonda Greer, now serves as vice president of the company and works along with her husband, Jeff Greer, who serves as project manager. Both are natives of Flint, Michigan. Incredible. And Jeff is also a former NBA player who played for the Golden State Warriors and Milwaukee Bucks for more than 10 years. So their history with Michigan is richly cemented. Quote, this is home for me and my family, and I wasn't going to sit back and do nothing as a person or a businessman, Mr. Greer said in an interview with TNJ.com. This is the biggest project our company has ever done, and as a result of the waterline contract, of our gross revenues have increased by about 70%. Wow. He continued, his expectation is to have 6,000 water lines replaced in the city by the end of this year. The target is to have all 18 lead-corroded residential pipes replaced by December 2019. Wow. That's incredible. That's incredible. So, family, this is exactly what I'm talking about, man. Black-owned businesses and working with local government, state on or local or on a state level, or even the federal level, for that matter. Getting contracts like this is few and far in between. So this is something that you have to talk about. I have to address this myself. You know, I want to see more of this. And I don't want to see, you know, black businesses get opportunities to do things in predominantly black cities. And this is exactly what I'm talking about, right? Exactly what I'm talking about. So much kudos to W.T. Stevens Construction. If they go public, if they have an IPO, I'll definitely purchase a stock. All right. Definitely purchase a stock if they have that available. All right. But anyway, family, those are my thoughts on that. Just a quick video. I wanted to share this with you guys. Till next time. All right. Make sure you guys follow me on social media. Both links will be down below in the description at The Black Separatist on Twitter and Instagram. Until next time, leave your comments down below. Also, Chauncey, aka The Black Separatist, signing out. Peace.